My name is Hunter here at Weather on the Go, and today is Sunday, June 23rd, and in today's weather forecast, we're going to be talking about more summertime heat, especially across the southern and southeastern U.S. going through the next 7 to 10 days and rounds of severe weather with some uncertainty as we move forward over the next few days. We'll be breaking that down in today's weather forecast, and we'll also preview the tropical weather update. Not much to talk about with the tropics right now. We'll get to that at the end of the video. If you are new here, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Give the video a like below if you especially like today's weather forecast afterwards. Leave any comments, questions, and concerns below. We'll get to those later on today. So let's look here at the geopotential height map. And basically what this shows is where the ridge of high pressure is strongest. And that is across California, Nevada, the Four Corners region there, into the Southern Plains and the lower Mississippi Valley. That's where the most excessive heat will be. And you can see this afternoon, here are your high temperatures across the Great Plains, across portions of the Gulf Coast here, and then back toward the desert southwest, a lot of those 90s out there, triple digit high temperatures this afternoon. When you factor in the moisture content in the atmosphere, this is what the air will feel like to your body as you walk outdoors, especially here. And this is also, by the way, measured in shade. So it's even hotter in the sunshine. So here you go, 108 in Tulsa, 105 in Oklahoma City and Wichita Falls, the Dallas-Fort Worth area, Shreveport, Little Rock, Memphis, 106, 101 in Nashville. Yeah, just a yucky day across portions of the southern U.S. with our heat indexes this afternoon. Now, we did have some big storms across the north yesterday that we did want to speak on here. We had a tornado on the ground in southern Wisconsin that did some damage into portions near Platteville and also Janesville, Wisconsin. So that storm did leave some significant storm damage behind in its wake and some damaging wind reports across the northeast with some hail reports mixed in as well. So another busy day on the northern and northeastern periphery of this ridge of high pressure. There's the cold front that brought all our big storms across Iowa, Wisconsin, Illinois, and into portions of Michigan last night that brought also some very heavy rainfall across those areas and some flash flooding. That will also bring more flash flooding concerns, but severe weather concerns to the northeast here already underway. We have a lot of thunderstorm fuel here lining up along and ahead of that cold front from the northeast down into the eastern Ohio Valley here into the mid-Atlantic states. And there you go. You have a level 3 out of 5 caliber severe weather risk day across Vermont, New Hampshire, western Maine, far eastern New York State, and into Massachusetts there. That is an enhanced risk with a slight risk down the Appalachians there into West Virginia, eastern Ohio, and into the eastern portion of Kentucky. Also a sneaky area of severe weather up here in northeastern Montana, northwestern North Dakota, that could bring some isolated storms as we go through the afternoon and evening today as well. Our main focus, though, is across the northeast. We have the biggest threat here of 60, perhaps 70 mile per hour wind gusts. So more tree damage is possible as we go through the day today. And a pretty heightened risk. An area that doesn't see a 10% chance of tornadoes very often is Vermont, New Hampshire, far eastern New York State, and into Massachusetts there near Boston as well. And then some of that tornado potential extends down back toward Pittsburgh, back there towards Scranton, into the Philadelphia, Baltimore areas, and then back toward Parkersburg there into West Virginia. So we're going to keep an eye on that as we go through the day. The hail threat's a lot lower. We have a lot of warm air aloft in the lower part of the atmosphere that's preventing those large hailstones from growing, but there could be some quarter-sized hail across portions of the northeast and mid-Atlantic, eastern Ohio Valley, and up here also into Montana and North Dakota with our surprise severe weather as we go through later today. Our main focus, though, is going to be on the significant storms over here in the northeast. That's the biggest, most main corridor of severe weather. Notice it's pretty scattered, so not everybody's going to see severe storms this afternoon. Notice a lot of these are supercells, so some tornadoes will be possible, especially maximized up there in Vermont, New Hampshire, eastern New York State, and Massachusetts. Heading into the evening, still pretty scattered as that cold front continues to trudge its way further off to the east. And then as we go into early Monday morning, a lot of this will move offshore of Nantucket and off of Long Island here and off of portions there of the mid-Atlantic coast as well, and will be much quieter in the wake of those storms to start off your work week there on Monday morning. And really zooming it out, showing you early Monday morning across the U.S., pretty quiet as well. Outside of a couple showers, rumbles of thunder for the Carolinas, Virginia, West Virginia, or down here in Dixie Alley, you know, it's hot, so we could have a shower storm to start off the day, but pretty quiet across the U.S. nonetheless. Now, going into the new week here, Monday, June 24th through Friday, June 28th, it's going to be hot. It's been hot. We're going to continue to see that heat intensify across the West. So the desert Southwest, the Rockies, through the plains, especially down here into Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas, just that yucky heat that we've been seeing will continue through the week. Looking at those temperatures, here are your highs to start off the work week on Monday, June 24th, Monday afternoon, well into the 90s. Again, areas like Wichita, Kansas City, in towards Springfield, Missouri, down here toward Little Rock, Dallas, Fort Worth, and Shreveport, Jackson, Mississippi, for example, back into the 90s on Monday. That'll continue on Wednesday. A little bit of a reprieve from the heat across the upper Midwest, the Great Lakes, and parts of the Northeast. So that'll be some good news. But again, look at the heat down in Georgia, Atlanta, Macon, Georgia, Augusta, all these areas will be into the triple digits possibly for highs on Wednesday. And then as we go into Friday, still the heat just continues. Yes, it's Texas. You're further south. It's summertime. You're going to definitely see a lot of heat out there. 90s, triple digits. As we go through Texas, Oklahoma, into Kansas, and much of the South and Southeast through the end of the week on Friday, June 28th. Now, make sure you know the signs and the differences between heat exhaustion and heat stroke. Heat stroke is the most serious. If you ever, you know, see anybody or experience any of these symptoms, confusion, dizziness, become unconscious, make sure to call 911 immediately, because that would be heat stroke. Heat exhaustion, you could have symptoms of dizziness, thirst, heavy sweating, nausea, weakness, okay? Make sure you know the difference. Stay cool, stay hydrated. It's most important to hydrate with water or any electrolytes out there and stay informed on the heat as well with such extreme temperatures. Now, we do have to keep an eye again on the northern periphery of the heat across the upper Midwest into the Great Lakes region through the week, especially Monday. And then into Tuesday, as a very strong belt of very strong winds in the jet stream will be moving through this area. And then on Wednesday a little bit as well, maybe further east. But I think the jet stream Wednesday midweek will start to become a little bit more disorganized further to the east. So let's walk you through this. On Monday, a very low confidence, uncertain day of how it will unfold with severe weather. The Storm Prediction Center only putting in a slight risk of severe weather, a level 2 caliber out of 5. Severe weather threat there for eastern North Dakota, Minnesota, into Wisconsin, parts of the UP of Michigan. This could get expanded. This could get upgraded significantly as we do get closer, maybe an enhanced or a moderate risk, depending on some of the scenarios out there. And the scenarios range from just a few thunderstorms to a derecho that literally could move through the upper Midwest. So looking at all of the instability building up Monday afternoon and Monday evening, look at this. You can see the blacks and whites here. That's 4,000. 5,000, 6,000 at max joules per kilogram of instability. This is thunderstorm fuel. The higher the number, the better the threat for thunderstorms and thus severe weather. So you see that setting up there with that gradient across the Twin Cities area, La Crosse, down toward Dubuque and Rockford, Illinois. And that would be the gradient according to the NAM model of where these storms could track. So looking at the NAM model, a couple of scenarios here. Monday afternoon, isolated, widely scattered storm activity from the Arrowhead of Minnesota back into northwest Wisconsin and toward the Twin Cities area, places like Duluth, Minneapolis, St. Paul. As we go into Monday evening, Monday night, there are a couple areas to keep an eye on here, Omaha to Des Moines, and then up here toward Green Bay, Marquette there into Michigan, keeping a close eye on that, maybe Rhineland or Wisconsin. We'll keep an eye on that as well, kind of a little bit more disorganized storms, but severe weather will be possible on the NAM model. Now, looking at the WRF FV3 model, does pretty well as well. You can see same start, just like the NAM model, isolated, widely scattered storm coverage Monday afternoon, but a bigger line of storms. This could turn into a derecho and track along that instability gradient through the Badger State of Wisconsin, and then have a tendency to drop south into the better instability there into northern Illinois, Michigan, and northwest Indiana. That would be something we'll have to keep an eye on. And the scenarios, which one happens, is actually very uncertain right now, even though we are just a day out from this event. And what happens on Monday will affect Tuesday. So here we go on Tuesday. Broad brush marginal, the slight risk of severe weather. This day also could get expanded and upgraded here much higher as well for parts of the Midwest, like Iowa, northern Missouri, southern Wisconsin, Illinois, Michigan there, especially southwestern lower Michigan into northern Indiana. Right now, a slight risk. This could change as we get closer. Lots of thunderstorm fuel available there, 4,000 plus joules per kilogram, actually maxing out about 5,500 joules per kilogram there on Tuesday. So far, Wednesday, don't have anything here highlighted by the Storm Prediction Center. The confidence just isn't high enough, but the learning model, the AI model that from Colorado State University is painting a broad brush, marginal to slight risk all up and down the eastern seaboard. So something we'll have to keep an eye on for the northeast again, along the I-95 corridor, the mid-Atlantic and the southeast, especially for the Carolinas, Georgia, and North Florida as we go through Wednesday. And you can see all the thunderstorm fuel out ahead of that. With that cold front dropping south Wednesday, plenty of that, especially with southward extent as we go into Wednesday for more severe storm potential. Now, we are tracking that storm, but a new storm will come in later in the week. This is on Thursday. Watching this trough up here across the southwestern Canadian prairies of British Columbia, Alberta, and Saskatchewan, and also up here into Washington State, northern Idaho, into western Montana Thursday. Going into Friday, this gets a little stronger, crossing through the northern plains into the southern Canadian prairies of Saskatchewan and Manitoba, and then crossing through the upper Great Lakes sometime this weekend, Saturday and or into Sunday, with all the heat building to the south of that. We have to watch it. The ensembles have been showing this, actually have bumped up the probabilities for severe weather because of the heat building to the south. We're likely to have another large reservoir of instability and thunderstorm fuel between that Thursday, June 27th and Saturday, June 29th time frame, and that could lead to another line of storms that could pack a punch with some damaging winds, hail, and a few tornadoes for a lot of the same areas there in the Midwest, from Kansas City to Des Moines, up here toward La Crosse, Madison, Green Bay, Rockford, and even Chicago. So we'll have to keep a close eye on that later on in the week. Also, the heat will be with us. Here's the weekend. This is next weekend on Saturday, June 29th. The heat will be a little further to the south. Where the exact northern extent of the heat lines up will be very dependent on the track of our next storm later in the week. But finally, by Sunday, the end of the month, look at that, the Twin Cities, you may not hit 70 for a high. So that, again, is very dependent on where exactly this next storm tracks and how it behaves as we go through the week. We'll keep you updated on that. Now, just touching on the tropics, right now, really not much to talk about in the Atlantic Basin across the tropical Atlantic, the Caribbean, the Gulf, nothing really to talk about here. A very small, very meager 20% chance of development near the east coast of Mexico. That is dwindling before our very eyes here, mainly just a heavy rainfall event, nothing with winds. Here are the Saharan dust from the Sahara desert over there in Africa. Look at all of the dust crossing through the MDR, the main development region, towards the Lesser Antilles today. That'll approach the Greater Antilles on Tuesday early in the week, and then by Thursday, maybe seeing some milky skies over here into the Western Caribbean, toward the Bahamas there in the southwestern Atlantic as we go into later in the week and toward the end of June. And this is also preventing a lot of tropical formation here because dry air with dust, not very helpful in any hurricane formation. Now, looking here at the Eastern Pacific Ocean, nothing happening either over the next 7 days. So the tropics pretty quiet for now, but what promises to be a very quick end to the hurricane season. With what I mean by quick end is that we're going to have a lot more storms to track, especially once we get to later July, August, and September. I think the tropics will start to really ramp up, and we'll have a lot to track across the, especially the tropical Atlantic, the Caribbean, and the Gulf as we go deeper into the hurricane season. So thank you all for watching. Make sure to subscribe to the channel down below. Like the video if you like today's weather forecast. Leave any comments, questions, concerns below. We'll get to those later on today. My name is Hunter with Weather on the Go, and I'll see you all tomorrow with a new weather forecast.